Early due diligence is underway on the potential sale and redevelopment of the Great Plains Synfuels plant. Mitsubishi Power Americas and Bakken Energy, which used to be known as Bakken Midstream, announced a strategic partnership to develop a clean hydrogen hub in North Dakota. They are interested in potentially purchasing and redeveloping the Synfuels plant into what would be the largest producer of clean hydrogen in North Dakota. During the press conference to announce the partnership, Basin Electric CEO and General Manager Paul Sukit says the Synfuels plant has provided hundreds of millions of dollars in benefit to Basin Electric.
When we first bought the plant 32 years ago, I spent 13 years of my career with it. And it's amazing to me, I've been close to it that whole time. And it's amazing to me, we've had people come in and say, well, let's try jet fuel. Let's try methanol. Let's try sulfur-free diesel. But every one of those are hydrocarbon fuels, carbon, right? It's amazing to me today we're standing up here and talking about taking that hydrocarbon fuels plant and turning it into a carbon-free plant.
Sukit also said the plant plays an important part in North Dakota's economy as well.
Many of you in this room know the positive effect this plant has on the economy of North Dakota and the Upper Great Plains. But this is exciting for us in another way because it greatly extends the life of this plant. And you're going to say, well, Paul, what does that do? I'll tell you what it does. It greatly extends the opportunity for our employees to maintain their jobs long term. And that's important to me personally, because let me tell you, this is a very, very good workforce. They're innovative. They work hard. They find ways to make that plant more profitable.
Sukit has assembled a cross-functional team of Basin Electric employees to evaluate the Synfuels plant's assets to Dakota Gas, Basin Electric, the membership, as well as to a potential buyer. This assessment will consider not only the way the plant operates today, but also that of the 45Q tax project, the primary reformer, and other potential impacts.